What's going on, legends? My name is Valued, and today we're going to be covering the best settings to get better FPS and stop having that annoying input lag. But enough talking about it, guys. Let's get right into the good stuff. When we talk about input lag, what does that even mean, or what is it? If you're wondering this, don't worry, you're definitely not alone. We've heard it called many things. Input latency and display lag are a few you might have heard this called. Basically, input lag is the time it takes for your monitor or TV to perform the actions you're inputting from your external device. These devices can be your controller or your mouse and keyboard. On many devices, you can see a specification for its latency. And the rating for this is always going to be in milliseconds, so you want it to be as low as possible. Wired almost always has a lower latency, so keep this in mind if you're playing on a wireless controller or if your mouse or keyboard are also wireless. Another thing you're going to want to check outside of Apex is your internet speeds, and if you can be hardwired on an Ethernet cable, that's definitely ideal for the best internet connection possible. On top of this, you need to double check those drivers and make sure they're updated so that your PC is running optimally for Apex. If Apex is performing at its best, then you know any lag coming from the game is not your PC struggling. And if you found your way to this video because Apex is not running well on your current setup, then you may want to make sure you have the requirements needed to run Apex well. Minimum requirements are fine for most games, however, Apex really struggles on anything less than the recommended specifications. There are some more advanced things that can be adjusted and messed with on your Windows settings or even some config files if you're wanting to go any deeper. But we're not going to discuss any of that in this video. And honestly, they're pretty daunting to do unless you're pretty experienced with your computer. Having someone with experience to walk you through it and ensure you're optimizing your PC for your game is definitely a great way to learn for the first time. Even though it's not specifically what they're for, ProGuides coaches can also help you optimize your game directly because most of them play on the most optimal settings possible. So if you find your game lagging and you want someone to help you out, be sure to check it out in the description below. Alright guys, so with many videos out there talking about why one setting should be one way and another should be this way, it's probably best we break down the important settings in a simple way for everybody. Under the video tab, we're going to talk about the first thing to look at, and that is the display mode. This we have found to be the best in full screen mode because the other ways offer slightly lower frames. However, this is up to you guys as it's really not a huge deal. Next up is the aspect ratio. Most players run this in native, but a lot like the better FPS you can get from 1610. But this hasn't been proven to do anything for input lag, even though some people say it does. Test it out and see for yourself is the best we can say with this. Another thing that has been said to lower input latency is the texture streaming budget being on the highest setting. Our Apex experts run this on maxed on 8GB due to the fact that it's said to do this. Unfortunately, there's no official evidence supporting this besides word of mouth in between high elo players. So we can't say for sure this is going to reduce your input lag, but man, does it feel like it. Now, there's actually settings that mention input lag, and that is VSync. If you want less screen tearing, but at the cost of input lag being increased, then you can try turning this on. But we doubt this is what you want to see since you clicked on this video. So toss that bad boy on disabled or the lowest setting you can stomach. This will ensure there's no delay to those sick wall jumps you're doing after watching our recent movement guides. Another setting to look at is going to be your model detail. Among other settings, this one is said to lower your input lag. Once again, we couldn't find the exact information stating this online. However, our Apex experts also run this on high, as do almost all the pros. The FPS difference from low to high is quite low, so realistically, we think this is why it's kept on high. So we recommend running this as high as you can. Now, the next setting is an interesting one because Ragdolls doesn't really seem like it would make much of a difference, but it definitely can. If this is on anything but low, this can sometimes cause a lag on your game when many people fighting are fighting around each other. So unless you really care about those ragdolling features, you should really turn this off to avoid having input lag. With so many settings in Apex, running the right ones for your PC is going to make a huge difference in the performance of your game and how you do in the game. Sometimes it's too easy to blame the game for running poorly when in fact we might not be optimizing the game the best we can. So check out the settings we listed, give them a shot in the firing range so you can really focus on the feel of things. Dialing in your input lag and even monitoring it can be really difficult, so this relies on you putting some time in to make sure everything feels quick and responsive. Also guys, don't forget about some external factors like internet speeds and the device itself like we talked about earlier. Most of these settings are some that people don't even think to change, but reducing your input lag is massively important in Apex Legends because it is such a fast-paced game. Anyway, guys, hopefully these settings helped you out, and we'll have another video coming out with new optimization features in Season 10. My name has been Valued, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.